In this video, I'll be showing you how to load the sample router and switch configurations into an HPE router and switch. To do this, you'll need a few things. Firstly, you'll need a PC, well, obviously, and it'll need to have a serial port. Now, nearly all PCs today don't have serial ports, though you can use a USB to RS232 adapter. To get the files into the switch and router, you'll need to install some sort of TFTP server software. I use a free version from SolarWinds. You'll also need some sort of terminal emulator software that can support a serial connection. I use PuTTY. You'll find a download link for these and other tools in the description. Motorola has provided a number of sample router and switch configuration files. If you've attended the Capacity Max training, these can be found on Motorola Online. Before loading the sample configuration into the router, you'll probably need to change the IP address on GE1. Here I'm using the HPE 2530-24 Ethernet switch and MSR2003-AC router. You don't have to use these models, but you do need to be aware of the hardware requirements listed in the Capacity Max System Planner. And of course, what I'm showing you here won't be applicable if you choose to use another brand. When you buy either of these devices, they are shipped with a console cable. If you've lost yours, you need to make another, which shouldn't be too difficult. Lastly, you'll need an Ethernet cable. You'll need to hook up the switch like this. The console cable goes between the PC serial port and console socket on the switch. The Ethernet cable goes between the PC and any port on the switch. Now, I'm assuming here that the switch is unconfigured. If yours isn't, you'll need to ensure that the existing configuration is erased. There's a description on how to do this in the HPE documentation. In the terminal emulator, you'll need to connect via the serial port using 9600 bits per second, no parity, 8 bits and 1 stop bit. Sometimes it's not clear which port a USB to serial adapter is sitting on, so you'll need to check this in Windows. Go to Device Manager and then to Serial Ports. In my case, the USB to serial adapter is on COM7. There are some commands you'll need to enter in PuTTY. The first is to set the IP address of the switch to 10.0.0.2. This IP address is only used to get the configuration file from the PC into the switch and will be deleted once the upload is complete and the switch reboots. Now you need to put your PC into the same subnet as the switch. In this case, my PC's IP address is 10.0.0.1. To do this, I use a tool called NetSet Manager. You need to start the TFTP server and make sure the config files are in the right folder. Next, you need to copy the switch's configuration file from the TFTP server to the switch. Once the file has been uploaded, you'll be asked to reboot the switch to get it to start up with the new configuration file that you've uploaded. Here is a summary of the commands I used here. The router setup is pretty much the same. The console cable goes between the PC serial port and the console socket on the router. This router also has a USB interface, and you could use that if you had the cable and driver. The Ethernet cable goes between the PC and GE0. This router has no configuration in it, so I can go straight into uploading the configuration file. Here are the commands you'll need to enter into PuTTY. The first is to set the IP address of the router to 10.0.0.2. This IP address is only used to get the configuration file from the PC into the router and will be deleted once the upload is complete and the router reboots. Next, you'll need to copy the config file from the TFTP server to the router. Once the file has been uploaded, you'll be asked to reboot it to get it to start up with the configuration you've just uploaded. The router and switch are now ready to use.